Member Chilliwack Kent.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. When Grace Baranek went missing in Chilliwack last summer, quickly followed by two other seniors, it became apparent that our searches could be more effective. Many suggested a silver alert system, similar to Amber Alerts, that would send a message to cell phones within a given area. However, an Amber Alert is passive. No one is activated by it to join a coordinated search. So I met with police to gather information. They explained that they are the first tier of response, employing officers, dogs, drones, helicopters, and other equipment to look for a missing person. Because time is of the essence, their intense activity is concentrated in the first few days. After that, I met with our local search and rescue group as a second tier of response. They are seasoned professionals who search via grid patterns, also using equipment, but they're more oriented to risky searches over large areas of rough terrain, rather than searches in dense urban areas. After meeting with volunteers as well, I think that what might help is a third-tier response team of committed local volunteers who would undertake low-risk searches in urban areas. At little to no cost, volunteers could register on a local Silver Alert Facebook site, take an existing online EMBC training course, and be ready to respond on short notice. Several members could become attached to local search and rescue units as resource members and be specially trained to lead searches in close coordination with police and SAR units. A non-profit Silver Alert Society was recently registered in BC. Community leaders could sit on the board of that society, which could then apply for funds to purchase any equipment local members need for their task. Finally, we would encourage the purchase of inexpensive GPS tracking devices for those with dementia to wear, which would make searches easy and save lives, time, and money. I know that the government is considering a silver alert system, and I hope that they'll think about a community-driven, voluntary effort, low in cost but high in effectiveness, to find and keep close those most vulnerable in our communities. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.